Hi guys, my name's Nick Jennison and I have a lick for you today, and it goes like this. All right, so what we've got here is a 3-octave legato pattern, unashamedly stolen from the mighty Guthrie Govan. This is outlining a C add 9 arpeggio, which in this case is functioning as an A minor pentatonic. Now, C add 9 is an arpeggio, has all the same notes as A minor pentatonic apart from A. And that's okay, because we're going to assume that somebody else in the band is going to be playing A, probably the bass player. Bass players out there, don't hurt me. Cool, so let's look at the first octave of this lick. It's going to take up two shapes. We're going to have a stretchy shape and an even stretchier shape, and they're both going to involve fingers 1, 2, and 4. So let's do the first shape. Okay, so our first shape is the stretchy shape, and it's going to go like this. We're going to have first finger on fret number 3 on your A string. Second finger will hammer onto fret number 5, and your fourth finger is going to hammer onto fret number 7. And the way we'll play this is we'll go 3, 5, 7, pull off to 5, pull off to 3, and we'll get this. Now, once we've completed this part of the lick, we're going to slide our first finger from 3 up to 5, and we'll play our even stretchier shape, which is the same fingers, and this time we'll get fret number 5, fret number 7, and we'll stretch all the way up here to fret number 10. Now, including the slide, this will go something like this. And those two parts together will sound like this. Now from here, what we'll do is we'll take exactly the same fingering shape, but we'll start it on the G string on fret number 5, which will give us this. Together, they'll give us this. And the final octave of the lick is a little more complicated because we've got an A note to finish things off. We're going to take the same shape. We'll start it on E, fret number 8, and we'll get this. And in this case, all we've done is we've tagged a little slide on the end from our little finger, which is on the 15th fret, that's where it finishes, up to the 17th fret, and followed up with another slide with the second finger doing the same two notes. So those slides on their own will look like this. And with the rest of the lick, it'll look something like this. Dead easy. And up to speed, it looks something like this. Okay guys, so that's a little bit of legato fireworks for you. You can throw that in next time you're in the key of A. This one also works as a pentatonic layer, which is a subject that I've talked about before, in the key of D, which is quite interesting. So that's a cool thing you can experiment with. You can also start this on the low E string, on fret number 3, and just move everything one string further up towards the ceiling to get a cool lick in the key of E minor. Or you can play these as C major, for argument's sake, as a C add 9 arpeggio. Or if you move it up a string, you get a G add 9 arpeggio, and so on and so forth. Lots of applications for this one. So have fun with it. Next time you're thrashing out some crazy shred backing tracks, or you're playing with your band, you can try throwing this one in and see how it works for you. Okay guys, this has been a lick for Licklibrary. My name's Nick Jennison, and I'll see you next time. Thank you very much.